Eventually, you'll need to invoice your customers for the various billable expenses and/or time that you've entered through QuickBooks. To do that, first click on Sales, and then choose Customers. Right here is a filter named Unbilled Activities. By turning that on, you'll see a listing of all of your customers that have unbilled activities. Unbilled activities can be time that are marked as billable and also billable expenses. Right here we can see that Amy's Bird Sanctuary has an unbilled amount of $3,550, which means that if we were to look at all of the time and billable expenses that have been entered for Amy's Bird Sanctuary, they would add up to that total. But their current balance is $0. They still need to have an invoice created for them that brings all of those transactions together onto one invoice that would actually be sent to the client. So to begin doing that, open the Create menu and then choose Invoice. Now let's enter the customer's name, Amy's Bird Sanctuary, and over on the right-hand side, a drawer pops out detailing all of the various time and billable expenses that we've assigned to this customer. Notice that each box represents a single transaction that has been entered in the past and was marked as billable. Here's a billable expense, and each day worth of time shows up as another box right here for billable time, and it includes the date that the time was performed for the customer as well as the billable amount. You can choose either to not group the time, which means that each one of these different time activities will appear as a separate line on the invoice, or you can have QuickBooks group the time by services. That way it'll make the invoice a little bit easier to read. These items can be added individually by clicking on Add, or you can add all of them at once by clicking this button. Notice that QuickBooks uses gardening as the product or service. This is the same product or service that was used on the time entered for the employee. And you can also see the time period as well as the description that was also on the time period. And there's also a quantity, rate, and total amount right here. On the second line is a billable expense, described as rented a backhoe for landscaping and then also a 10% markup. The customer by default will not see this. Instead, they'll see one line for $550 with a description of rented a backhoe for landscaping. If you'd like to see the transactions that QuickBooks is using to build this invoice, just click on Linked Transactions up here at the top left, and you can see all of the billable time and billable expenses that QuickBooks has used to derive this information. Also, if there are any other changes that you need to make to any of the products or services, quantity, rates, or amounts, or if you just want to include something else that wasn't on the original billable expenses and time, you can click on this line right here and continue to add more and more products and services. Your invoice options are the same for any other invoice right down here at the bottom. And now let's save this invoice by clicking on Save and Send to email it out to our client. Here you can change the subject or body of the email that'll be sent to the customer, as well as a PDF preview, which the customer will see, and then send and close. Now when we look at the customer's list, we can see that Amy's Bird Sanctuary has an open balance of $3,550, and there is no longer any unbilled activity. Use invoices to group together all of the billable activity for your customer.